How's it going, everyone? This is Mr. Morales. Today I'm going to show you how to create a small JavaScript program. JavaScript is a programming language that we use. Mainly, it's embedded in HTML to increase some functionality. So here is the program that we're going to create. It's a Hello World program. And pretty much a Hello World program is a beginner program that a lot of first-time programmers use to learn some very, very basic programming concepts. I would say most programmers start off with this program. So let's take a look at what we have here. It's Hello World, Mr. Morales, my message. So we have two buttons here. I'm going to click the message button and the text Hello World comes up. I'm going to click the clear button and the Hello World message erases. So we're going to create this. So we have our document here on the desktop already. The name of the file is called morales-daniel-javascript.html. Now your file is going to be named differently, obviously. So I'm going to go ahead and double click on this, and now let me show you what we have so far. So obviously we're missing the buttons. We don't. This is all we see here. So let's look at the code. So in order to look at the code, what I need to do is I need to open this up in either WordPad or Notepad. If you're using a Mac, you can use text edit. So you can either open the program and open it from there, or what I like to do is I like to right click, open with, and we'll go to Notepad. Let's take a look at what we have here. So far this is all we have. What we're going to do is the first thing you want to do is change the name. So go ahead and change the, erase Mr. Morales and put your name on there. And let's take a look at some of the tags here real quick. So some of these you're already familiar with, so I'm just going to go over one tag that you may not be familiar with, and that is the div tag, which is this one here. So think of the div tag as a container. When we create HTML documents, we like to section things off. We like to create sections. So we use the div tag to create sections. So for example, here we have a div and it's called main. So this div goes all the way up to here. So here's the starting point and here's the end tag. Okay. So we can either we can also have containers within containers, or div tags within divs within divs. So here's another one, and we use ID to be able to know the name of that specific div. So we have our open div here, we have it closed here, and this is our header div, and we use that as for our so that text that you saw, Hello World, and then you're with the name on it. We also use IDs to reference other tags. So in this case we have the paragraph tag, and we have the ID called demo, and this is where we have the message. Okay, I'm going to create another div here, or let's create another one here. Let's type in P. So I'm a fast typist, so I typed it all in there real quick. So let me explain to you what I just did. So I created another paragraph tag with an ID called a message. So and this is the area where when we click on the button, this is where the text Hello World is going to appear. So in the place of the text, we just put a break tag right there. So this is in order for there to be some type of placeholder. And then we end our tag here. Okay, if you don't understand everything, hopefully by the end of the video you'll be able to understand this a little bit more. Next thing we want to do is we want to let our HTML document know that we're going to be using JavaScript. So after the title tag here, we want to create this text here. So I'm going to type it in there and you guys can copy it. So what I created was this text here. This text is used for letting your document know that you are going to be using JavaScript. So script, so open bracket script space type equals, and in quotation marks we type text backslash JavaScript quotation marks and bracket, and then we close it with the end tag there. Okay, so now what we're going to be doing is we're going to be creating a function. So I'm going to type in the function, you guys copy it down, and I'll explain to you what that function is. So I'm going to press enter, I'll press tab on the keyboard, I'm going to type the word function. So a function, think of it as like a subroutine or a special procedure, or think of it as a little mini program within the whole program. You'll see what it does. We're going to call the function. So whenever you want certain events to occur, you need a column. So in this case, we start off with the keyword function, and we're going to give it the name, this function, we're going to give it the name change text. We're going to use open and close parentheses. We'll do a space, squiggly mark, press enter twice, press tab, close squiggly mark. Okay, you will press tab again twice, and now here's where we're going to do some interesting code. You may not understand everything here, but what we're doing here is here, let me type it in here first. Document.getElementById, and basically what we're doing is this code, what we're doing is we're looking at, we want to reference, or we want to look at a portion of the document, or the portion of the document that's called message. Okay, so we're going to type in quotation marks message and quotation marks close parenthesis dot inner HTML, like that, inner HTML equals, and then in parentheses we'll type open quotation mark hello world, close quotations, close parentheses, and the semicolon. So basically what we're doing here is we're locating this message container, which is here, and inside the message container all we have is that break. But what we're doing is with this code is we're changing that break into this text called hello world. Okay, so that's all we've done so far. Now what I want to do is we got to create a button that's gonna call this function. Alright, so let's go down here towards our last paragraph mark where the message container is at, or ID is at. So I'm going to press enter, type spacebar three times there. Now I'm going to type in open bracket button type equals, and then in so here we're going to create what's called the onClick event. So the onClick code is a code that we used to trigger an event. So here we're going to type onClick, we're going to type in, we're going to call, this is what we call the function called change text. Okay, so it gets kind of complicated with all these different brackets and all these different things. So we make sure you type everything exactly the way, if not, because if you don't, then it's not going to work. Okay, the name of our button is going to be called message, and now we're going to close that button. We're going to leave it like that. Okay, so basically what you're going to be able to see is a button, and you'll be able to, the event, the code is going to be called change text. So this, what you're doing once you click on that button, it's calling this thing called change text. It's an actual function, so it's basically going up here and then it's doing whatever the code is between these squiggly brackets. Okay, so let's take a look at that. Let's go to file, save, and let's go check out our code so far. So here's what I have. So here I have the button there. Notice I have the space here that I wanted. So now when I click on the message, it says hello world. Great, fantastic. But now we need another button to clear it so we can erase this. So let's go back and let's do that. So what I'm going to do is create another function. So I'm going to go here at the end of bracket. I'm going to press enter and I'm going to type this function, and then you guys can copy it. Okay, so let's take a look at what happened here. So I created this function. It's called clear text. Basically it looks very similar to this, with the exception of the name, which is now called clear text. We're doing the same thing. We're going to be changing this element called message, and instead of the hello world, we're going to create this, we're adding a break tag there, okay, to create some space. What we also need is another button. So I'm going to show you a little trick here. Basically copy and paste. We'll copy that. Okay. And we're going to change some things here. So this time the onClick event is not going to be called change text. It's going to be called clear text. So let's change that. And this time the name of the button is not going to be called message, it's going to be called clear. Let's file save, let's make sure everything's saved, it looks good. Let's go to our code. Excuse me, let's go to our browser and let's look at that page. Okay, so here we are, but I don't see the changes, so I need to refresh it. So I'm going to click on the refresh button. Bam, there, and now I see my two buttons. Now I see my message. So I'm going to click message. I get to see the hello world. Clear it and it goes away. So there you have it. We just created a small, very basic program using JavaScript and HTML. This is a very popular program that a lot of programmers begin with. It's called the Hello World program. So hope you enjoyed the video.